Hello to you, friends. This is Early Buddhist, video log number 5 on the Four Noble Truths, Arya Satya. But first, the normal intro. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the Blessed Buddha. Remember your ticket to the deathless dimension of Nirvana by clicking subscribe under the video here, lower right on the small red sign, and also the small bell on the lower left side, and the thumbs up under the video if you like it. First, a small meditation hall building report, a Dhammasala report, and it comes right here. Thank you.
should not think it, but for this small 6 meters of cement wall, we used 8 bags of cement and 40 bags of sand. There's 40 mixes of this wheelbarrow of cement. Today we're gonna mix and make the rest of the foundation down to here. I'll probably use also 7 or 8 bags, maybe only 6 bags. Then a lot of bags of stone, of cut stone, and then the sand that stands over there. Very nice weather for cement work. Nice to see the wall finished, then I can take off the scaffolding and start to build the new wall over there along this edge. Thank you for your support, friends, and may this be a benefit for many beings up here on the Misty Mountain. Umbrella, Central Hill Country, Slovenia. Scaffolding has been filled with cement and it's dry, and tomorrow we'll start taking off the scaffolding so we can use the planks for something new, and this will be along this edge next corner. That will be the next job. Thank you for your contribution, attention, and consideration. Thank you. As you see, friends, the first quarter of the foundation of the meditation hall has been unpacked, and a nice foundation cement wall has appeared. This was the first quarter. Not perfect in first try, but not too bad either. Thank you for your attention, clever consideration, and kind contribution. Thank you.
Yes, friends, then back to the core of all Buddhism, the Four Noble Truths. the Gautama Buddha on this quintessential core of Buddhism. He said, "Bhikkhus and friends, there are these four noble truths." What four? One, the noble truth of suffering. Two, the noble truth on the cause of suffering. Three, the noble truth on the end of suffering. Four, the noble truth on the way to end suffering. These are the four noble truths. What, bhikkhus and friends, is the first noble truth on suffering? These five clusters of clinging are suffering. The cluster of clinging to material forms, rupa, and thereby also all bodies, kaya, is suffering. The cluster of clinging to mental feelings, vedana, is suffering. The cluster of clinging to mental perceptions, experiences, sanya, is suffering. The cluster of clinging to mental constructions, sankara, is suffering. And the cluster of clinging to all kinds of consciousness, vijnana, itself. Consciousness itself is also suffering. This is verily the first noble truth of suffering. What, bhikkhus and friends, is the second noble truth on the cause of suffering? It is craving tanha, which leads to renewed becoming, joined by delight and lust. Seeking delight now here and later there. That is, craving for sensual pleasures. Craving for becoming, for example, rich. And this and that. And craving for not becoming, for example, sick. And this and that. This is indeed the second noble truth on the cause of suffering. Craving. What, bhikkhus and friends, is then the third noble truth on the ceasing of suffering? Yeah, it is a traceless fading away and complete ceasing of that very same craving. The giving up and relinquishing it, the freedom from it, and the non-dependence on it. This is actually the third noble truth on the ceasing of suffering. Ceasing and silencing of all craving. What is the fourth noble truth on the way leading to the ceasing of suffering? Yeah, this is a sober and noble eightfold way, namely right view, samadhi, right motivation, sammasankappa, right speech, sammavacca, right action, sammakamanta, right livelihood, sammajiva, right effort, sammavajama, right awareness, sammasati, and right concentration, sammasamadhi. This, friends, is the fourth noble truth on the way leading to the ceasing of suffering. These four bhikkhus and friends are the four noble truths. Therefore, bhikkhus and friends, an effort should be made of, much of, so to completely understand, this is suffering. This is the cause of suffering. This is the end of suffering. And this is the way leading to the end of suffering. An effort should be made now to understand, comprehend, penetrate, recognize and realize these four truth. Thus said the Buddha. And all these extracts coming now is from the group saying of the Buddha, the Samyutta Nikaya, section 5, book 56. This is a Satya Samyutta, the Connected Discourses chapter on the truth. Friends, here comes another one. Once, a certain not very well-known bhikkhu asked the Blessed Buddha, "Venerable Sir, ignorance, ignorance is it said. What is ignorance? Venerable Sir, in what way is one wrapped up in ignorance?" The Blessed Buddha Gautama then pointed out, "Not knowing suffering is ignorance. Not knowing the cause of suffering is ignorance. Not knowing the end of suffering is ignorance. And not knowing the way to end suffering is ignorance. All this absence of understanding is ignorance. And it's by that very blindness, that dark state of blocked insight, that one is wrapped up in ignorance. Therefore, bhikkhu, an effort should be made much of now to understand. This is suffering. An effort should be made much of now to comprehend. Such is the cause of suffering. An effort should be made now so to realize that this is the end of suffering. An effort should be made now to penetrate, recognize and develop the Noble Eightfold Way leading to the end of all suffering." Once again, a certain not very well-known bhikkhu asked the Blessed Buddha, "True wisdom, it is said. True wisdom. What is really true wisdom? Whenever, sir, when has one arrived at such true wisdom?" The Blessed Gautama then pointed out, "Understanding and knowing that this is suffering is true wisdom. Understanding that craving is the cause of suffering is true wisdom. Understanding that no craving is the end of suffering is true wisdom. Understanding that the Noble Eightfold Way ends all suffering is true wisdom. All this profound, transcendent understanding and direct knowledge of the Absolute is true wisdom. And it's that very penetrating comprehension, that glimpse of a far-reaching ultimate reality, that one has arrived at true wisdom. Therefore, bhikkhu, an effort should be made much of now to understand. This is suffering. An effort should be made now, much of it, now to understand. Such is the end of suffering. Therefore, bhikkhu, an effort should be made much of now to understand. This is suffering. An effort should be made much of now to comprehend. This is the cause of suffering. An effort should be made now so to realize. This is the end of suffering. An effort should be made now to penetrate, recognize and develop. This is the way leading to the end of suffering." Samyutta Nikaya, number 5, 425-6, section 56, Asaka Samyutta. Thank you for your attention.
So as you see here, pretty nasty weather. So you see here, friends, a nasty misty weather, typical for cloud forests. It is drizzle, and because you're basically inside a cloud. But nevertheless, we will not waste the time just because of bad weather. So why not take a shot at the core of Buddhism, the Four Noble Truths. The deep cause of suffering is ignorance. And ignorance has a cause. It's not a cause. And so what is the cause of ignorance? Most deep down, it is not knowing, not seeing the Four Noble Truths. So, as the Buddha pointed out, it is because of not knowing, not seeing these Four Noble Truths that both you and I are still in samsara. Both you and I buzz around here in the dark, in the mist, and in the rain. Have to go to job every day, blah blah blah, pay tax. Sometimes goes to war even. So a significant effort should be done now, while we still are able to do it, to come to realize these Four Noble Truths. So to come to realize the Four Noble Truths is something else than just intellectually knowing them. This pariyat, the theoretical knowledge, it starts with that. So one has to know them theoretically to take it to the next level, where one practices the Four Noble Truths. This is a pariyatti, now pattipatti level. So the level of praxis. And it is here that at some level there will come penetration to either 25, 50, 75, 100% realization of the Four Noble Truths. 100% entails the arahat stage, 25% the stream entrant level, 50 and 75% the sakadagami, once returner, and anagami, non-returner level of realization of the Four Noble Truths. So this is important to get, because it's only having become a stream entrant, one is safe from downfall. That is to say, safe from animal rebirth and lower than that, safe from hell, basically. Therefore, it's right to say that these Four Noble Truths are really the core, the central core of Buddhism, around which all the other aspects and teachings and techniques, they are circling around these Four Noble Truths. Because it is for the purpose of realizing these Four Noble Truths to 100% degree that one escapes suffering, that one becomes enlightened. So it's not a small thing. Unfortunately, this seems to be forgotten, or at least neglected, or diminished, or reduced in the later developments of Buddhism and the later traditions. But in the early traditions, you really still get a firm handle on these Four Noble Truths, which are one, or this, out there and in here, back then and in any future, and right now also. All this and such is suffering. Suffering, not happiness. Not attractive, not appealing. It looks like happiness. Yes, it looks just like happiness. But then it ends. It ends in disappointment, in frustration, in fear, in anxiety, fear of losing, an
anxiety over that, because the mind, of course, have tried this 100,000 times before, and more than that. So it knows that it will lose every joy it has and every happiness it finds. It knows it in advance, subconsciously. And this is, of course, create anxiety. As long as what? As long as the second noble truth is working. And what is the second noble truth? That is that this suffering is caused by craving. Tanha, literally meaning thirst. Thirst for life. Thirst for pleasure. Thirst for becoming this and that. And thirst for not becoming, avoiding this and that. Most notably, craving for sensuality, craving for seeing something, hearing something, tasting something, touching something, smelling something, and perceiving something with the mind. Craving for becoming rich, famous, respected, beautiful, and all light states. And craving for not becoming. Vibhava tanha. Praying for not becoming notably dead, but also insignificant, disrespected, criticized, especially rightly criticized, and all other disliked states. It is this craving that creates suffering. Right there, realizing that, within one also sees the end of suffering. Which is, of course, ending all craving. This means no craving, no suffering. As simple as that. So this is the third noble truth. That ending all craving, silencing all craving, stilling all craving, eradicating irreversibly all craving, is the irreversible end of all suffering. It goes by the cause and effect, that it is so. So then, the job then is obvious. That is, the job is to end craving. End craving for sensuality, end craving for becoming, and ending craving for non-becoming. Well, how to do that? This is the Four Noble Truths. This is to develop, refine, and complete the Noble Eightfold Way. Nothing else can silence craving, and nothing else can thereby irreversibly, finally, completely, absolutely, end all suffering. So, as the Buddha also noticed, if you see one truth, you see all four truths. So understanding one leads automatically to the next one. So it's a win-win situation. You just have to pick one up, then you get the rest for free. Almost by a little reflection. The Four Noble Truths is the core of Buddhism. Why so? Because their realization is the end of suffering. It's equal to lasting happiness. Is equal to the end of samsara, this time ocean of suffering. Not too bad that somebody has told us that, huh? This the Buddha told us. Should be very grateful for that. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the Buddha. And now? As we just talked about the Four Noble Truths, a small amount of sun comes right through the clouds. Yeah. Some additional points. Don't need an umbrella in clouds. Neither in sunshine. Oops. Crossing a small stream here. It can be very, very, very slippery down there. I poked a hole in my head some years ago. I slipped on this slope. Because when it's wet, then they become algae, and then the algae becomes like soap. Whoop! Acute suffering. Dukkha dukkha. Some additional remarks. About these Four Noble Truths. Is that if not realized, then this ignorance, this not knowing, not seeing, not acting upon or out from, not behaving based on these Four Noble Truths, this keeps us in samsara. This means that it keeps beings. It keeps killing beings. So, this ignorance of these Four Noble Truths is a serial killer. As long as the Four Noble Truths are not realized, then one keeps coming back here. One is kept in circulation. With a higher low. So if one feels sorry for oneself for becoming old and decaying and dying eventually, or one feels sorrow for others for their aging, sickness and death, then one should know, this is caused by ignorance. Ignorance of what? Ignorance of the Four Noble Truths. Neither more nor less. That's what kills you. Huh? A form of blindness. Not seeing, not knowing. And therefore not realizing the long-term effects of this very deep down ignorance. So, what is the purpose of life anyway? Yeah, easy to see, is it, that all beings, whatever they do, in all their moments, they try to escape suffering and attain happiness, attain lasting happiness. Usually they fail. They find only momentary happiness. But nevertheless, the purpose of their being alive and running around, bussing around, doing this and that, up and down mountains, for example. This is to find this lasting happiness. So can happiness and suffering coexist? No, they cannot. If there's happiness, then there's no suffering. If there's suffering, then there's no happiness. So this means, actually, factually, and also seen through the Buddhist mirror, obviously, that one has to eradicate suffering in order to find lasting happiness. So how then to eradicate suffering? Yes, since the deep down root is caused by ignorance of the Four Noble Truths, then obviously one has to realize that this is the case, and then work for the understanding and continuous awareness of this Four Noble Truth in all one's doings. Awareness of suffering, awareness of craving, creating suffering, awareness of the ending of craving induces absence of suffering, and awareness of the Noble Eightfold Way that leads to the silencing of all craving and thereby all suffering. So you can say the first truth of suffering, it has to be experienced. One has to experience suffering so one can understand it, really. The second noble truth, that craving is causing suffering, it has to be understood. And the third noble truth of the ending of craving, and thereby also the ending of suffering, has to be realized, has to be made real, has to be made a fact in every moment of conscious continuity. And the last noble truth, the fourth noble truth, has to be developed, thereby fulfilled, completed by repeated attention and thus refinement and expansion. So, first when you experience that this world and this so-called self and this body and all others' bodies are suffering, then you will be able to understand that it's craving that causes the suffering. And this understanding will gradually lead to, point to, incline towards ending craving, silencing it, giving it up, relinquishing it, and thereby realizing this end of craving, this stopping craving, this absence of craving in any moment. First stopping it a moment here and there, then later down the road stopping it for minutes, and then later down the road for hours and for days, still having latent tendencies that comes and bang you in the neck and say, hey, hey, you still like this and that, you're still addicted to this and that, so you still suffer, bye bye. But eventually, it will be overcome. You'll be defeated. How so? This has come by developing, cultivating, expanding, refining, making more accurate, making more deep, making more generalizable this Noble Eightfold Way, which is right view, samaditti, right motivation, sammasankappa, right speech, sammavacca, right action, sammakamanta, right livelihood, sammajiva, right effort, sammavajama, right awareness, some sati, and right concentration, some samadhi. That's the deal, friends. No other hanky-panky, funny hats, rituals, silk, or big churches can do the trick for you. You have to do it yourself. The Buddhists point out the way, the method to make the medicine. But you have to make this medicine yourself. This raft that will bring you to the other side of suffering, that will bring you to Nibbana. Neither more nor less. As such, the teachers have given us that recipe, that cookbook, that method. But if we fool around, neglect it, nothing happens. This is not to blame on the method. This is not to blame on the Dhamma. This is not to blame on the teachers. This is to blame on oneself. And what's foolish fumbling around with all kinds of paraphernalia, inessential items, distractions, obsessions, and what have you out there in the jungle, in the samsaric, endless, wet jungle of wrong views. And we are right back in the monk studio, the cypress tree and the stone, as you see, where all the videos are taken, and here the cypress tree. Thank you for your attention, and have a nice and long day. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the Blessed Buddha. Thank you.
Friends, some commentary on the Four Noble Truths from the Visuddhimagga, the Path of Purification, from the 4th century. As the Fourth Noble Truth always say, all this and such is suffering, dukkha. 2. Craving is the cause of suffering, craving, tanha. Ceasing of all craving is the end of all suffering. 4. The Noble Eightfold Way is the method to end all suffering. These Four Noble Truths, Arya Satya, are the core of Buddhism. 1. All this, internally and externally, past, present and future, is suffering. Suffering is of three kinds. A. Obvious suffering, which is any bodily pain and any mental sadness. B. Suffering due to change includes also pleasant feeling, as in this also becomes quite disappointing when it inevitably fades, changes and vanishes. And C. Suffering due to the construction is that all is conditioned, and since all is thus, later inevitably destined to fall apart because it's a construction of several parts. This also includes any object which induces a neutral feeling. The First Noble Truth points out that all worldly phenomena and things, ultimately speaking, is suffering. And this First Noble Truth has to be fully understood in all aspects. Second Noble Truth: craving is the cause of suffering. Craving, tanha, is of three kinds. A. Craving for sensuality, craving for sensing, experiencing forms, sounds, smells, tastes, touches, and mental states. B. Craving for becoming. For example, may I become rich, attractive, young, famous, etc. or liked states. And C. Craving for non-becoming. Example, may I neither become sick, nor old, nor dead, nor criticized, nor insignificant, nor poor, nor any other disliked state. This second noble truth on the cause of suffering, craving, it has to be eliminated. It has to be made nothing. 3. This absence of all craving is therefore the end of all suffering. A. Not craving for any sense stimuli or any contact of any kind. B. Not craving for any kind of re-becoming as this or that in any future. C. Not craving for any non-becoming by accepting all ills that inevitably will come. The third noble truth on the end and absence of all craving, and therefore the end of all suffering, it has to be accomplished. It has to be realized. It has to be fully real. This absence of all craving. The Noble Eightfold Way is the method to end suffering. This is the fourth noble truth. Which Noble Eightfold Way has to be developed in order to end all suffering? 1. Right view, Samaditti. 2. Right motivation, Sammasankappa. 3. Right speech, Sammavacca. 4. Right action, Sammakamanta. 5. Right livelihood, Sammajiva. 6. Right effort, Sammavajjhama. 7. Right awareness, Sammasati. 8. Right concentration, Sammasamadhi. This fourth noble truth on the way to end suffering, the Noble Eightfold Way, it has to be developed. So the first noble truth on suffering has to be understood. The second noble truth on the craving as a cause of all suffering, it has to be eliminated, this craving. And the third noble truth, this absence of all craving, has to be realized, has to be made real and irreversible. And the fourth noble truth, the noble way, the method, it has to be developed. Thank you. Lastly, what is the meaning of the four noble truths? This and such is suffering, is the first noble truth. The meaning of this suffering is oppression, when pain is being formed due to the burning of frustrated desire, created when the wanted object changes into something else, now undesirable, and thereby always and inevitably lost. This is the meaning of suffering, which is real, neither unreal nor otherwise. 2. Craving is the cause of all suffering. This is the second noble truth. The meaning of craving as the origin of suffering is something that is stored and accumulating. Since this source and cause of suffering means addiction, obsession, enslavement, and bondage, and thus vulnerable and unfree in this dependence. This is the meaning on the cause, which is real, neither unreal nor otherwise. 3. Ceasing of all craving is the end of all suffering, is the third noble truth. This meaning of ending craving, ceases suffering, is escape, escape, since one now has become sheltered and protected due to the suffering not being recreated and accumulated when the cause of craving have subsided and been all silenced. Ending craving means deathlessness. This is the meaning of the end, which is real, neither unreal nor otherwise. For the Noble Eightfold Way is the path and method to end suffering. This is the fourth noble truth. The meaning of the Noble Eightfold Way is outlet, exit, since this method causes exit from the state of suffering. Thus knowing, thus seeing and understanding what is real and what is the dominant releasing factors that has to be developed into a unity. This is the meaning of the way, which is real, neither unreal nor otherwise. Thank you. Source, the Visuddhimagga, Path of Purification, 494.